you. Cool. Awesome. Hi, everybody. Well, it's great to be here today. Basic income. Before I even start with this, let me ask people a few questions here. Who here, can someone explain basic income to me in your own words? Who wants to give a try? What is basic income to you? It's a loaded term. There's a lot of different definitions. Yes, sir. I like that very specific definition. Yes, that I jive with. There's a lot of different ways of structuring a basic income. Like if you look at how the cost of certain goods and services have increased over the past few decades, you'll see that housing, healthcare, and what's the third one? Housing, school, yes, education. Those just have been skyrocketing, but everything else, the cost has been dropping. So if we wanted to be very specific about it, rather than just giving people money, we could just give people some share of equity or literally just give them education, healthcare, and housing for free. But that's a lot, that's pretty complicated. I think the easiest way to do this, and I've been thinking about this for 8 years now, and I've been trying to solve it for 8 years now, on and off. Like, I'm not just like working on it full time, but to me, it's like the end goal of all of this. Like, I am not in Web3, I am not in blockchain to improve money. I'm here to make money irrelevant. Because if we look at Star Trek and we look at these sci-fi novels where we live in this world of abundance, where automation is doing everything for us, it's just generating all the food that we'd ever need, clean, limitless energy, you know, how do we get to that society? Like, money is not relevant in that society where you can just get anything you want and there's no scarcity, right? And that's where we're getting to. We're getting to a world of abundance with enough automation and if we have limitless energy and all this stuff. But I think we'll get there. And basic income is one step on the ladder to get there. And so all that is to say that, you know, a little bit of philosophy here on why I'm doing this and why I think this is important. I want to get to a world where everybody has all of their basic needs met and they can not work just to survive. They should work because they want to work. You know, we have such a limited time on Earth. We shouldn't just be like, so many people hate their jobs. And I feel like, right? I feel like if we had a basic income, it would definitely decrease human suffering in the world. Now let's get to the implementation. Enough of the philosophy and like, you know, utopia stuff. So how are we going to do this? So when we think about basic income, there's several ways of structuring this. There's one way is, let me just, you know, create a web app and I will have a server client architecture. It's a Heroku, you know, web app, node.js, and I'm connected to Stripe. And anybody who wants money, I'll just create a pool of, you know, USD. This is like V1. This is before we get to Web3. And I have a pool of USD. Let's say it's $200. And I create a scheme where anybody who signs up as a user is going to then receive, you know, a penny every day. And there's a limit there, right? Because eventually the money's going to run out. Well, I could ask people to donate money for charity and that's going to keep it going. That would work, but it would be limited to people who can receive USD, people who have bank accounts. And ideally, to me, what a basic income looks like is totally global. It is not based on your nation state. It's not based on your zip code where you grew up. It is just a global cryptocurrency. And in order for that to happen, we can't use something like Stripe or any of these Web2 fintech products. We have to use something that is inherently distributed, decentralized, like these cryptocurrencies are. And so which cryptocurrency to build? This is where the tribalism comes in. Well, you know, we have number one, the king, we have Bitcoin. But when it comes to Bitcoin, we can't create something, a token, that's going to accrue in value as more and more people use it. This is not, I mean, we could with stacks and like some kind of weird sidechain atomic swap thing going on, we could do something like that, but it's still not, no one's really done it. That's why. I mean, I'm sure it's possible, but nobody's really done it. When it comes to like actual tokens that accrue in value and that people actually use, day to day, like Sweatcoin, an app that I downloaded that gives you money to walk It's like proof of mobility. Super cool. It's from the UK. Yeah, it's got 5 stars on the App Store. Sweatcoin, check them out. But they're an ERC-20 token, which is built on Ethereum, as everybody here knows. So Ethereum would be the solution here to build some kind of basic income token that's we can be very specific about. But the problem with Ethereum, and there is a problem, there are two problems actually. The problem with Ethereum is that it's really expensive to use in terms of gas fees, and it can be pretty slow. The throughput for transactions is not that good. And there's several reasons for this, and we know that the core ETH team is working on solutions to this. For layer one, for the main chain, they're working on sharding, which is taking a bunch of data, splitting it up into several chunks, and distributing it across the network in the hopes that throughput increases. So sharding, we have one. There is increasing the block size. That's another one. There's changing the consensus algorithm from proof of work, which is what it currently is, to proof of stake. All this is great. They are doing as much as they possibly can. But if you look at Vitalik's blog post, there is no ETH2 without layer 2. Layer 2 is a part of the ETH 2.0 upgrade, which is not a one-day event. It happens over time. Who knows how long that's going to take, though? That could take forever. But you need another layer. You need an execution layer. In fact, I don't know if you guys saw this, but they stopped using the terms L1 and L2 like officially. Now it's the execution layer and the consensus layer. And so you can have the execution layer, but you need that. You can have the consensus layer, like the main chain, but you need that execution layer. And that's what Polygon is. And that's why I work at Polygon. So I've been a YouTuber for 5 years, full time, my own boss. It's been great. I've been loving it. But I joined Polygon because I feel as excited about Polygon today as I did about Ethereum 5 or 6 years ago, because in the end, I only care about the end result. Can we create scalable dApps for users? And I remember the students in my dApp class 5 years ago that I hosted on the internet, they were building amazing dApps across every industry. Social networking dApps, decentralized Uber, decentralized Airbnb. Did any of them pick up? Did any of them gain mass adoption? No. And why? It's because they ran into these problems. High gas fees and slow throughput. And that's what Polygon solves as a separate chain. Right now, it is what's called a Plasma sidechain. But Polygon has spent over $1 billion on acquiring almost every reputable zero-knowledge roll-up startup. So all that talent and technology is there. And Polygon today, there are thousands of dApps that have been deployed to Polygon that are scalable, and they're, you know, QuickSwap, Uniswap. If you go to awesomepolygon.com, you can see literally thousands of them. And the great thing about Polygon is that if you are an Ethereum developer, which I assume everybody here is or wants to be, if you are an Ethereum developer and you want to make a super scalable, really feature-rich app, you can just do that. Forget about Polygon. Just focus on Ethereum. I've got my Truffle library. I've got Ganache. I've got all of the suite of tools that come with Ethereum. You can build that and you don't need anything having to do with Polygon. You know, Truffle for smart contracts, Ganache for a test blockchain, Drizzle for your front end, things like that. If you don't want to use that, there's Hardhat, right? Who here has used Hardhat, by show of hands? Okay, nice. So we got some serious people here. So we got Hardhat. I like Hardhat as well. You know, it's like an alternative to Truffle. It's pretty cool. In terms of what I get to actually compile and work, it's probably more like Truffle, but like I want Hardhat to work, but it doesn't. It's like, it seems like it should be cleaner. So all of these tools you can use to build your Ethereum dApp. Now, to make it run on Polygon, all you have to do is change a single line of code in your, let's say for Truffle, it'd be truffleconfig.js, or in Hardhat, it would be like, I think, a command line where you just change the RPC from the Ethereum, whatever, testnet London to the Polygon testnet, which is Mumbai. Okay, so that's it. You're just deploying your Ethereum dApp to a different chain. And then what you do is you let Polygon do the rest. Polygon's validators, the people who are securing the network through staking, they will send your transaction data to the Ethereum main chain every X interval. And what Polygon is also working on is adding to this send a proof of validity proof, a zero knowledge proof. Now this is in works right now. It's very R&D. If you want to get started building these zero knowledge proofs on Polygon already, you can do that. You just have to go to our latest acquisition, which is Hermes, scalable payments. And, you know, I've tried looking at this SDK. It's still like really hard to use, so I wouldn't recommend it. We want to take this and like put it into the Polygon SDK, so it's a little easier. In fact, the ideal goal is that you don't have to do any of this. Like, this should be just built into the chains. All you have to do is build your apps and the features. So, okay, that's the first 10 minutes. I've got 10 more. So that's me. That's enough of me shilling Polygon. Let's get to what this basic income smart contract looks like. So let's write this out in Solidity. So we're going to call this basic income. ETH, Denver.solidity. Great. Okay. So let's just write this out. All right. This is going to be 80 lines of code, and we're going to think about all of the gotchas here and things that we can do better, things that we're doing well. So first, we're going to say what version of Solidity we have. And I'm going to say it's, you know, 0.4.21, probably not the latest, but I don't care. And then we're going to create our smart contract. We're going to call it a basic income token. Now, this token, what we want is we want each person to have a token. And we don't want a single person to be able to say, I'm John, but I'm also Bob and Mary and Alice. And, you know, we want one person to receive the token. We don't want them to be able to create 30 different accounts and receive that money, because that would be cheating the system. We need some kind of way to create what's called a proof of unique identity. What does that look like? And that is the problem that I haven't quite figured out how to do. And so many super smart people have been working on this for years. And there's like this idea of a decentralized ID, and, you know, of all people, Microsoft, you know, worked on that. There's this idea of reputation, right? The longer you've been on the network, the more money you can get. And the oldest accounts in the network, those are the ones perhaps at some interval after you've been, you know, a part of the network for say 2 months, then you get the funds unlocked. There's a lot of different ways we can do this, but let's wait for that super hard problem till the very end to try to solve that. So let's just keep building here. So we have our token. We're going to call it basic income token, or BI for short, basic income token. That works. And okay, so we have a name for it. We're going to have a supply now for it. So how many of these do we want? Well, I'm going to say, you know, in Solidity, you want to use an integer, and you want to specify the byte count. So I'm saying 8 here. I'm going to say, okay, so how many decimal places do we want? We just want 0. So we don't want it to be a lot. Now, how many of them do we want, right? So if we are making a basic income token for the entire planet and for every human, we need some billionaires. Yeah, we need a lot of these tokens, right? So I'm going to say that we're going to have, I think there's like 8 billion humans-ish, right? So something like that. But just to be safe, let's say 9 billion. Because we're planning for the future here, like Satoshi did. 2140 is when the last Bitcoin will be mined, I think, something like that. Let's assume, everything has an expiry date. It's not like this is going to be like forever. So let's assume we need this until we hit the singularity and like we become superhuman gods. So that's probably within 50 to 100 years. Let's be, you know, real, like within 100 years, we're not going to be these like meat bags, like definitely not. So total supply, I would say, so in 100 years, how many humans will we have? We probably have like, let's say 15 billion max. So we'll have 15 billion tokens, and everybody will get a single token. And once you have your token, that token is your identity. It is your unique 25-character alphanumeric identifier. Then once you have that token, we will send you dividends every day. So you're earning money every day using this identifier. So the dividends are the actual income. The token is the identifier. And we have to switch how we think about that, I think, in this case. All right, so we have 15 billion. So let me just make sure I've got all these zeros here. Yeah, okay. 15 million, there's our billion, great. Okay. And now we have our constructor. If you are new to Solidity, one thing that got deprecated was naming the constructor the same as your smart contract file. So we have to just call this constructor instead of calling it basic income token constructor. So that's just like a weird thing that changed. But as that's how it goes. So we have a balance of, we're going to start off with the total supply, and we're going to initially assign all of these tokens to the contract's creator. We need one place And the creator doesn't have to be a human. The creator can be a smart contract. It can be a machine. But we need some place for those tokens to live before they're distributed. And so we're going to give it access to the total supply. So the initial balance will be the total supply. And once we have that, we're going to fire a transfer function, which we haven't written yet, where we're going to give every address that signs up in an array, so we're going to start at the first address, some token from this supply. Okay, and so initially we're going to give the whole supply to this first address. So that's going to be the first transfer. We're going to keep using this transfer function over and over and over and over again. So we have our public function, we have our constructor, we did what we had to do. Now let's start writing out some of the more hard functions. So we have the constructor. Let's get to naming some variables that we're going to need later on. We're going to need we're going to need to know what the balance of the dividend is. Like, how much do we want to give people? We know the token supply. How much do we want to give people every week? Because we can give people thousands of tokens a day, but what does that equate to in value? And see, I'm still thinking in terms of USD. I'm trying to change that frame. If you think about the price of a house in the past year, it has, in terms of USD, it's gone up. But in terms of Bitcoin, it's actually gone down. So that's a different standard that I'm trying to, you know, re-architect my mind around, and I think it's a good thing. So we have a balance of, and so what does this, how many tokens do we want to give as a dividend? We're going to say, to keep things simple, one, and just let that accrue over time. As there is some scarce resource that people pay for with this token that gives it the value, in this case, I would hope that it would be basic necessities like food and housing and health and things like that. And we could even architect it so that we are partnering with other Web3 companies that are on-chain that offer on-chain housing and on-chain health and this. And so we can limit what the tokens are spent on to addresses on those chains if we wanted to. And if this is a DAO, which I would assume it must be if it's a global basic income token, then we can have proposals for that. And what does that look like? So we have our address. It's going to be a pretty big number, so we're going to have it be a 256-bit number. When I say big, I mean it can be very fractionalized, so a lot of decimal places. So we have a dividend balance of, that's the first variable. I also know I have 2 minutes left, so we're gonna do this faster. Okay, uint 256. We're gonna how many, that balance of is our first variable that we need. We also need to know how much dividend per token. And the last thing we need to know here is who was this credited to? Where did we send the token? So we want to keep a record of the address that it was sent to in a decentralized way instead of on a server, so that we don't send the same person the same token over and over again. So I'm going to write out one more function here. Actually, since I have 1 minute left, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write out the headers for these functions that I'm going to have. Like I said, there's going to be a transfer function that takes the address as an input, and it takes the, you know, where it's from and where it's sent to as the parameters, and then we have a value. How much are we sending? And lastly, the last function is called approval. Who here is approving the send of each of these tokens? And there's a lot of different ways we can architect how approval works here. We can have it so that there is no approval. We can have it so that one owner approves of everything. We can have it so the network must vote on who gets it and when. And I think that would be honestly be better for a global basic income token. We would want it to be based on a vote. I think that would be, you know, the best. In-person what? In-person key sign. Yeah, I never thought about that. In-person key sign. Yes,
WorldCoin.
Okay, so we're like, let's talk really briefly about WorldCoin. We have to. Okay, so transfer approval. And so there's like 40 more lines here, but I'm not going to have enough time. But you guys get the basic idea. By the way, this is not possible today because this is a dream that I have. I want it to work, but nobody, including myself, have been able to figure out every single detail. I have like a general vague idea, and I just really want it to happen. And that's why I kind of named this talk that. I hope one of the super smart people here can work on and make this happen. I'd be happy to work on this with you in whatever form. Contact me afterwards. I'm very interested. I've always been interested in basic income. And the last thing I want to talk about, since we're a little bit over time, but we just have to talk about WorldCoin if we're going to talk about basic income. So Sam Altman, the YC guy, made this thing called WorldCoin, and this thing had so many memes on Twitter, this like eyeball thing, whatever the hell. I get it. It's so noble, and I love it. I love that they're working on this big time. Definitely like read the white paper for WorldCoin. I think that's a good starting point because they really put a lot of thought into the documentation behind this. And here, they're like solving the unique human problem. Remember I said, like, how do we prove that you're a unique person in this decentralized way? And their thought is that we're going to give everybody this robot ball thing, and they're going to scan their eye, and nobody else has the unique eye signature that you do, so there you go. And how many ways can you game this? I can name a lot, right? You can just use an AI to generate a deepfake version of an eye. You can, it's like a cat and mouse game. As good as we get on the security end, we're gonna get just as good on the defense or the attack end. So all that is to say, definitely look at WorldCoin. Thank you guys for being here today. Build with Polygon. I am here. Talk to me afterwards. I love to talk to people. Thank you very much.